Add and subtract fractions with different large denominators. When the denominators are large, we will most likely need to use prime factorization. To find the LCD. And then to build up the LCD, we're going to multiply by any missing factors. So let's see how this works. We'll start with example one. We have 24 and 36. Since I don't know what would be the LCD off the top of my head, and the numbers are a little bit big to just kind of actually try to write out the multiples, we're going to do prime factorization here. So I'll start with 24, and I know that that's divisible by 2, which gives me 12. And 12 divisible by 2, which would give me 6. 6 divisible by 2, so that would give me 3. So that would be 2 cubed times 3. For 36, again, I'll start with 2. 2 goes into 36 18 times. 18 divided by 2 would be 9. And 9 is divisible by 3, which would leave me with 3. So that one will leave me with 2 squared times 3 squared. So our LCD then has to be 2 times 3. We take the highest exponent for each, which would be 3 and 2. Now that I have that, I am ready to rewrite my fractions with the common denominator. Now, one thing that I tend to do, especially when my numbers are bigger, is that I like to leave the multiplying my denominator out, or the LCD, until the very end. That way, if I have common factors, it's already broken down and easy to see what those common factors would be. So what I have here now is we had 7 24ths, but that was 2 cubed times 3. And we had 11 36ths, but 36 was 2 squared times 3 squared. Now we want the denominator to be equal to 2 cubed times 3 squared. Hope everybody's following that okay. So when I look at my first one, I notice that I'm missing 3. So that means I'm going to multiply by a 3 here. So I'm going to have 7 times 3, which would give me 21. Now when I look at my 11 36ths, I notice that I'm missing a 2. And all I'm doing is counting my exponents. For my 2, I'm going from a 2 to a 3. And for my 3 squareds, I've already got that. I'm just missing 1, 2. So I got 11 times 2, which would be 22. Now we were adding those, and so I'm just going to add this vertically because I don't want to do a rewrite of all of this. So I have 21 plus 22, which would give me 43. Since 43 is a prime number, it will not have any factors of 2 or 3. So that means I can multiply my 2 cubed times my 3 squared. So 2 cubed is 8, and 3 squared is 9. So 8 times 9 is 72. So that would be my answer. I only do this when my numbers are really large, because it is hard to reduce when the numbers get really big. Let's take a look at our other example. 90 is not a multiple of 54, so I'm going to need to do the prime factorization. So I'm going to take 54 and divide it by 2, which would give me 27. 27 divided by 3 would be 9. 9 divided by 3 would be 3. So my prime factorization for that one is going to be 2 times 3 to the third power. Now, my 90, well, 90 is divisible by 2, which would give me 45. 45 is divisible by 5, which would leave me with 9. 9 is divisible by 3, which would leave me with 3. So my prime factorization for that one is 2 times 3 squared times 5. So that means my LCD now is going to be 2, 3s, and 5s. My highest exponent for 2 is 1. The highest exponent for 3 is going to be 3. And the highest exponent for my 5 is going to be 1. Okay, so now let's do our rewrites. So I started with 5 over my prime factorization for 54, which is 2 times 3 cubed. And then I had minus 7 over 90, which was 2 times 3 squared times 5. I want those to have a denominator of 2 times 3 cubed times 5. So when I look at my first one, I've got my 2 and my 3 cubed, but I'm missing the 5, so that means I need to multiply by 5 here. And 5 times 5 is 25. When I look at my second one, I've got my 2s and I have my 5, but I'm missing a 3, so I need to multiply by a 3 to get the correct denominator. So I have negative 7 times 3, which would be a negative 21. At this point, I'm now just ready to add, or in this case, subtract. So I have 25 minus 21, which would give me 4, and that's all over 2 times 3 cubed times 5. And since I left it in its prime factored form, or LCD, I can see that I have a common factor of 2, so I can divide that out. And then once I divide that out, I'm left with 2. I have 27 times 5 here, so I'm going to have to do some multiplication off those side here. 5 times 7 is 35, 2 times 5 is 10. Plus 3 is 13. So it's going to be 2 over 135. And that will be my answer.